Alola friends, DapperDraby here, and welcome to another PTCGO video. I'm sorry I've been a little hiatus on these lately, but I finally have a deck I'm comfortable bringing you guys. I don't want to just like throw some trash together and say, hey, does this work? And then it doesn't work, and I look foolish. Or I play Greninja and I look foolish. So I wanted to make sure I tested a couple of things before I brought you a new video. And today, no Crimson Invasion. We're not doing any of that. We still don't have enough cards for any of it anyways, so there's not really a big deal on that. We can finally make an Executor deck, so maybe I'll do that in the near future. But we're probably going to slowly dwindle off on some PTCGO so that for the Christmas holiday, I'll be spending that with my family, so I really want to focus in on that. So there'll be a week or so without... No, there'll probably be a week. Yeah, it might just be a week. It might just be a week without any videos that are not the countdown videos, because... So I'm dwindling it down to nothing, and then New Year starts, and we'll start with a bang, guys. I know I should be getting these things uploaded earlier. Fortunately, that's not really possible sometimes. So we get it up when we can get it up. I've started a new job, so it's been a learning process again of, you know, changing schedules, trying to figure out, you know, when's the best time to record. When's the best time to schedule stuff, and I'm gonna have to start bulk recording stuff, but it's kind of hard to do with everything else going on in life. So let's get started today. What I want to bring you guys today is Latios from Shining Legends. This is a promo here because it's a beautiful card, but the main guy is not that guy, right here. Latios. I tried to read Breakthrough and Latios at the same time. So Latios is known for its Breakthrough attack. Does 30 damage to one of your opponent's bench Pokemon and does 30 damage to the active. This is a pretty sweet attack. I mean, Buzzswole does very well with it. Of course, it helps that he's a fighting type. But, so I kind of took this idea. I looked at some Buzzswole decks and said, okay, well, what's pretty successful? And I looked at it and I was like, okay, so it does well with Garbodor. That doesn't surprise me. You shut off abilities and you can start hammering in, which really does help this deck. If you shut off abilities, they're not as easily able to overpower you, but with 110 HP, they're basically one-shotting you. So you want to spread some damage. And then I have an option for a de-evolution play in here. So it's pretty standard, spread damage, de-evolve to catch up in prizes. You actually could play counter energy and counter catcher in this and be pretty successful as well, I would say. But let's go over what is in the deck. We have a Latios, of course. We have four of them because they are the main attacker. But let's go to the beginning, guys. The beginning, we have a Oranguru. Instruct ability is super helpful. You're not always able to use it, but it's useful in a pinch, and it helps out in some key areas. And then Psychic's not a bad backup attack. 20 damage times the amount of energy attached to your opponent's active Pokemon. If they generally have 3, that's 120 damage. That's nothing to scoff at. That's pretty good. So we got one Oranguru. We have one Marshadow-GX. This is mainly for that Zoroark matchup. If we end up facing Zoroark and we have a Latios in the discard pile, we can use Breakthrough and do 60 damage to the Zoroark in the active. So that's mainly why we have Marshadow here. We're not going to use Beatdown. We're not going to use Peerless 100 Blows. We're just basically going to use the ability Shadow Hunt, which is counterintuitive, and you'll see why in a second. We also have two Tapu Kokos, which is a promo, so it's pretty easy to get. I was trying to make this a very budget-friendly version, so you'll see, you know, promo, theme deck, promo. This is probably the hardest card to get in this set, in my deck right now. So we got two Tapu Kokos, which you can get from a pin collection or a figure collection, which is pretty cheap, I would say. Flying Flip is just an amazing attack, does amazing damage, is able to spread some things, then 20 damage to each of your opponent's Pokemon. It really adds up. If you have 3 turns of Tapu Koko with no answer, you're screwed. Like, it's really hard to come back from it. And then one Espeon-GX for that miraculous shine. We can attach a psychic energy and de-evolve. And then worst case scenario, you know, if we run into a Ninetales, we can just Psy-Shock it. Because this attack isn't affected by effects of your opponent's active Pokemon. So there's no dig protection. There's no protection against Espeon. Espeon's going to break through that and get to you. So that's pretty cool. And then, yeah, Miraculous Shine. Everybody knows what Miraculous Shine does for Espeon. De-evolution. We have one Latias in here, which came with the promo Latios, which is pretty cool. It allows Latios in play to have no retreat costs, which is awesome. I'm pretty excited about that. So it's flight support. And then I've actually was surprised that I did end up using Misty Gale once on against the Gardevoir matchup, because they put up 90 damage on my Garbodor, and I just was like, well, I'm going to heal some of that. And it did 60 damage, so I thought, oh, I can set up the de-evolution later. So I'm surprised. Latios is kind of nice. It lets you retreat your Latiases so that they can kind of shuffle around and you can get the attacks that you want in. Main dude. And then we have Necrozma, mostly for the Black Ray GX, but we are playing a Psychic deck, so Prismatic Burst could come into play. Again, promo. You can get this out of a 10, which is pretty sweet. So like I said, this is very friendly, budget-friendly deck list here. Of course, we gotta start with the... Actually, this is probably the most expensive card in the thing. Or you can just open up a bunch of Breakthrough like I did and get a couple of them. So we got Trubbish, and... Oh, we got one Guardian's Rising Garbodor, the Trash Lance. You just never know when you can use it. It can just... It's really a one-of. Trash Lance is like your GX attack. You play it down when you count your opponent's item cards and just give one big hit KO, and then they usually find a way to counter it. It's pretty much that simple. So that's why we're playing a one of. And then we have two Garbodor Garbotoxins, which we can attach a tool to it and shut off abilities. And ability shut off is very good in this deck, so that, you know, Decidueye can't feather arrow you, they can't use their draw supporters and all that jazz. All right, moving on to the items. We're playing Evosoda because generally we can get a Trubbish down first turn, but it's really hard to find the Garbodor afterwards. So Evosoda can kind of help out with that. If you draw an Evosoda, you just play it down, evolve in the Garbodor, and really threaten your opponent with that ability lock so that they can't do anything. You can get this as early as second turn, and it's great. Two Field Blowers to take out some tools that are unwanted or stadiums that are very helpful towards our opponent, just to try to just put it back in our favor. You know, if they have a Parallel City and we can only play three bench Pokemon, then, I mean, how are we going to get out of that? We Field Blower it. We got four Nest Balls because almost everything in our deck is a basic. We play no Leles. We don't need Ultra Ball. For that reason, it's really the only thing that you have to use Ultra Ball for rather than Nest Ball is the Garbodors themselves. So why not play four Nest Balls? We play one Special Charge because we are a DCE deck. DCE dot deck. We play two Super Rods, and I opted for a Super Rod over Rescue Stretcher due to the fact that we play a lot of Psychic Energy. So I thought it'd be good to be able to get back the energy as well as the Pokemon. There's nothing that I feel like I just desperately like need to pull right out of the discard and play down again. It's something we can always shuffle back into our deck and draw into again. We are playing three Ultra Balls because we don't need the four count because we're playing all basics. One Gladion. This is just a way in case something like a major is stuck in your prize card. If you have like two DCE stuck in your prize card, you're like, oh crap. So you can kind of adjust up according to that. You know, actually what would be a good card in this deck would probably be Dimension Valley. But considering we're playing in standard, it's not possible. But if you play expanded, this deck could actually be a little bit better. But then again, it would probably be similar to the Zoroark Psychic deck that won in Japan a little while ago. We also playing three Guzmas, and I just thought that actually Guzmas could be replaced with Countercatcher if you want to go even cheaper. Because Countercatcher, you're going to be down in prizes. You're spreading damage and then just going for one knockout, a bunch of knockouts all at once. So Guzmas helpful for that, but it's also helpful. Reason I like Guzma is because you can like Guzma out of the active and then spread damage a different way, so you can actually get damage spread across the board rather than just on one or two Pokemon. I'm playing four in as the major draw support in this deck. We really don't have a lot we want to throw away. So we're playing in to keep everything in our deck and keep drawing. A couple different art forms of it, of course. Three Sycamores, because it is a really aggressive draw supporter. We really want to use it, but we don't want to throw away a lot of resources. We want to be able to get it and select the last card in our hand and then draw seven new cards. We're playing Shauna as a third supporter. I really feel like that's the way to get around not playing Lele or, you know, big draw supporters like Zoroark, Octillery, all those cards. So I'm playing three Shaunas, which may be replaced by something like Cynthia when that comes out. It could even be replaced by Lily or Sophocles. Those are also two very good things, but I didn't really discard too much, so I chose Shauna over those two guys. Three Choice Band, because when we hit GXs, we want to hit hard. We want to hit for 60 damage and spread that 30 damage. We're playing four Float Stones because Garbodor. We want him to be able to float out of the active. He's a heavy trash bag, you know. If we all had Float Stones for our trash, we would all be happier people. Four Double Colors, and to end it all out, we have, I think it's six, it might be five now. It is five now. It's five Psychic Energy. I had six, but I wanted to add in Gladion, I think. That is the deck, guys. Let's take it to the versus ladder and go ahead and see how it plays. We're playing Breaking Through. I don't know. Our Breaking Free. I was going to call it Breaking Free, but Breaking Through works too. So hashtag Breaking Through. I've had a breakthrough. There we go. Hashtag I've had a breakthrough. Okay, let's see what Latios can do. Is it any good? Can it compete? And I think it can. I mean, nobody's playing Latios. Latios Garb. Has anybody ever heard of that? This is a number one idea, guys. You're not going to see this anywhere. And this guy has the advantage because he's playing Zoroark. So this is why we play Marshadow, right here. I did a test run before I started recording. I came super close to beating Gardevoir, but of course Gardevoir has those max potions, and those max potions allow it to heal off that damage that I spread it. So it's like the max potion is the anti-spread deck, so it really sucks sometimes, but it is what it is. So I wasn't able to take down Gardevoir, but I came very close. If I would have just been able to... I got 60 damage from two different Gardevoirs, and they healed all the damage off, which I was like, dang it! Look at that, two Nest Balls. We're getting a good start here. Go ahead up there, Trubbish. We got the Float Stone to float you out of the active. You're not quite as heavy of a trash bag, but you're still pretty hefty. This is Wimpy, and then Garbodor is hefty. If you guys have seen that commercial, you'll know what I'm talking about. Hefty, hefty, hefty. Wimpy, wimpy, wimpy. I don't think Trubbish is a wimpy garbage bag, though. I think Muk is a wimpy garbage bag, because it's all over the place. What are we playing? I see a... They're gonna Alolan Grimer, Salazzle. They're going back that way. Interesting. So that's Nest Ball. Go ahead and pull out our Latios. We can Nest Ball again. And we can pull out. Ooh, who do I want? Am I gonna be able to get down to three cards? No. Not really. Down to three cards, and Latias is prized, guys. So I guess I will grab Oranguru, just so we're on the safe side. And go ahead and throw the DC there. Float Stone on Trubbish. And they have three cards, we have three cards. I don't really want to do this, but I want to see if I can get anything here. Definitely not going to end them. Ultra Ball. That could work for next turn. So maybe I'll hang on to it. Retreat. We can do exactly what we want to do here. And just throw a little breakthrough out there, guys. A little breakthrough. Show the speed of Latios here. Latios is super fast. If you get aggressive with it, you can really surprise them. How much HP does... Grimer has a total of 80 HP. Jeez. Cool, they end us. So we didn't have to use our M. Keep it down for another day. Ooh, and we got the... got the Ultra Ball, so we can really knock out this there goes a Latios. Really? Oh yeah, I forgot I had to reinstall, so there's that. I said okay. Back off. So paralyzed all that jazz. What do I want to do here? Part of me wants to go for the ability lock here, but they don't really seem like they're using ability lock that much. They're trying to set up this play here and hope that I don't get tail so they can chemical breath for the knockout. Let's go with that. I guess I will Ultra Ball away the Field Blower, which is questionable at best. And, ooh, this is tough choices. Tough choices. I'm gonna say the Float Stone. Let's see what I can get here. I can shut off abilities. And I don't have anything that can, like, rush in. This is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna grab my shadow here. Go ahead and throw it down. DCE it up. Ooh, you're right, Oranguru. I can draw one more card. And then one more card, it doesn't matter. Shauna! Ooh, we get the choice. Get the choice. We have a choice here, guys. We have a choice. What's in our discard? None. So Marshadow can come in and beat that up next turn. I'm gonna go ahead and put the choice there and pass. Let Muk take out my Necrozma. This is why you don't throw down your GXs. This is why I was skeptical of doing it in the first place, because unless you're ready to use Black Ray, you really don't want Necrozma down on the field because it's an easy two prizes for your opponent. Same thing with Marshadow, but I have a Psychic Energy in hand. If Necrozma, he has to pick one. He has to pick Necrozma or Marshadow because Marshadow can come and hit him for 120 damage next turn by using Necrozma's attack. 60 more damage, or 70 damage for, so it'll double to 140. Well, actually, it'll double to 200 because I have the choice band. So, Marshadow has everything he needs to be able to take out Muk. Question is, what else does, is that Guras? Going for it! Going for the special energy! Muk, discard energy from your opponent active. He's not my active. He's not my active. Oof, you might regret that. Like I said, Marshadow has everything he needs here. Ah, I have too many Latios. I don't want all this. So let's go ahead and I would say N. Still the float here, I guess, and N. I don't need those two cards right now. Ooh, nice. We get another choice band, which we'll throw onto the Latios. Nothing we need to field blower here. We got a DC for next turn. We are just gonna go ahead and Prismatic Burst to take out this monster. It's that weakness damage. And we're tied up again, guys. So unfortunately now this might end up being a Marshadow show. Oh no, I can just retreat him. I had to use the energy to retreat him, but I can just retreat him. So this is going to be an interesting matchup because I forgot to go through everything, you know. Really, they're double evolving. They don't want to double burn it? I don't think you can double burn it. That was an odd play. I think this next turn I'm just gonna retreat Marshadow. And spread some Koko damage. Some Koko Puff damage. Bridgeting to set up their bench. With an Oranguru, a Grimer, and a Salandit. They're really gonna make themselves have nothing in their hand. Well, I'm gonna just get rid of all those tools. All those tools are gone! So you retreat to one that can't do anything. Hey, I'm unburned. Still poisoned though. And I draw for turn. It's a Sycamore. Let's just go ahead and get rid of their tools here. Marked in yellow, marked in yellow. And honestly, ooh, I could Guzma and keep the DCE. That might be fun. So I could break through here, but I actually think Koko might be the better option. What's something big that we can trap here? That's two retreat, that's one retreat, three retreat, but he turns into Muk. He's the main attacker. So I would say Oranguru or that. Let's bring out... Sure. Let's bring out the vision. Grammar, get our Marshadow unpoisoned. No reason to play Super Rod just yet. And then we're just gonna flying flip.
Four times and they are in serious trouble.
Sorry if the audio cut out there for a second. De-evolution spray on the Salandit. They're gonna poison me. I don't think this is gonna work out too well. And an N! Oh no, there goes my four cards and I get another four cards. So I'm not too upset about this. We're about mid-game here. And there we have it. Both the ability blocker and the ability to get the ability blocker. So we wouldn't even have to use, we wouldn't have to throw down the Garbodor. We could get a different Garbodor to thin the deck out. There comes the Alolan Muk. And it's a bad idea to knock out Koko. You can trust me on that, bud. They rely so heavily on Instruct here. Ooh, bad idea. I'm unboined. I'm unburned. Oh, I could retreat and then re-retreat. That's not bad. I could be a jerk. I can't actually. Never mind. I thought I could be a jerk and like use Necrozma's attack again, but I don't have no psychic energy on him again. So, what's the best choice of action here? It's probably to. Yeah, I know. Yeah, let's go ahead and Guzma up something. I like Muk. So I'm going to bring up Muk. Go ahead and retreat Oranguru back into the Koko. And the problem with this is that I can Ultra Ball for the other one. And then draw two more cards. Let's do that. Probably a dangerous move, I must say. Then we can instruct for two. Ooh, we get the DCE, that's nice. And we throw down the Garbodor. And block all abilities. That is my last DCE, so we're gonna hold it for a moment. Yes, I know this. I didn't know it prompts you for that. So we're just going to spread some damage here. One more Koko and we can de-evolve Muk into Grimer to knock it out. And I believe some of these Salandits are the same way. That one's ready to be de-evolved. That one's almost ready to be de-evolved. So there's a Salandit I can just take out with Latios, and then there's a Salazzle that can be de-evolved for another prize, and then we can could probably just take out this Muk with Marshadow. They got rid of my floats. They wanted their abilities back. Would they get rid of Float Stone and what else? Had to be something else, a Choice Band, I guess. Could they get off the Choice Band? Oh, they're worried about the Marshadow. The Marshadow can one-shot Muk if he has the a psychic energy and a Choice Band. Is that super rodding in? Yeah, they're super rodding those back in. Chemical breath slows down us a bit, takes out the Koko for sure. The question is, what do I want to do now? Because Marshadow can hit it for 40 damage every turn right now with that. Yeah, because he can use Prismatic Burst and he can use Flying Flip. He can also use Black Ray GX. And that's damage, right? That's not... This attack does 100 damage to each of your opponent's GX. This damage isn't affected by weakness or resistance. Wait, how am I already, like, being timed out? This makes no sense. Let's go ahead and retreat into him. I'm gonna hold it. Yeah, I'm gonna hold it. So I guess we will... Actually, we need another attacker. Let's go ahead and throw Latios' energy down there. Instruct for one. It's an Ultra Ball. And then go ahead and break through. Taking out... not taking it out. Setting up a de-evolution on three of their main Pokemon. We just need an Espeon and a energy. So next turn, as long as they don't take out a Oranguru, we can Ultra Ball away Latias and whatever we draw to be able to de-evolve three with Espeon. So now we can actually hit for 60 damage on this Muk, which is not quite enough. They're gonna try to take out the Marsh, which is fine. Just fine. He wasn't apparent for our win here. So let's go ahead and throw the Oranguru down. A Koko. Tapu Koko. So we're gonna go ahead and throw down Espeon. We will go ahead and throw two things away, grab a Trubbish, all the trouble in the world, and lean heavily on this Oranguru. Be able to pull us a psychic energy. Go ahead and Shauna for good measure. And retreat into Espeon, causing that miraculous shine. Now I know Muk is not a tier 1 deck, but it was a good matchup between these two, so whoever gets this last prize is the winner, guys. It's one-on-one, I took out his major attacker. I think it's asking him who to promote. The second energy, and last card is a Super Rod. And also the funny thing is, look at this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 item cards. So if we get the other Garbodor, it can just wreck house right now. Although, I think if we also get... might be able to put Latios out here. Ooh, there we go. Anything we can hit for like 70 damage. That perfectly. So, let's just do this. Guzma up this Alazzle. And Lagoon Flight for the win. Well played, game. Well played game from an Alola Muck player, which I support you. I think most people have upgraded that deck to be Nihilego over Salazzle. But that was fun. We cannot look at their deck, unfortunately. But look at the MVP was Tapu Koko, actually. So is this a Koko deck or is it a Latios deck, guys? You tell me. Let me know down in the comment section below. You know, if you guys, what you guys think of my GX plays. I mean, they almost cost me the game, to be perfectly honest. In a higher tier deck, they would have cost me the game, I would say. But on that note, guys, thanks for coming out. Oh, did we get the Glaceon? No, we didn't get the Glaceon. Okay, so let's go to our collection real fast here and see what we can open for packs. We have 12 Crimson Invasion and one Burning Shadows and four Guardian Rising. Let's open Guardians Rising. We have four of them and they're all locked. So let's see what we get here. It is a Chansey, the Trubbish, Alolan Bulbix, that Beacon, Max Potion, Salazzle we just beat with a Talonflame actually. So three more packs. Let's see what we get. A Barboach, Choice Band, Field Blower, Reverse Foil is a Drampa, and our rare is the Rainbows! The Rainbow Turtonator, such a pretty card. I like Rainbow Turtles. It's Raphael for you guys right there. Can't expect anything else better than that. You know, Secret Rare Turtonator, the Turtle Dragon, but our rare is a Kamo-O GX. And the final pack of Guardians Rising is going to be Stufel on the ground having a good time. Beware, and a Trevenant, which is not a bad rare. Not a bad rare. So thank you guys so much for coming out. sorry, I started choking. This is DapperDraby. I'll bid you guys Alola, and I'll see you on the next video. Have a good night. Bye-bye.